Let's go to the East Coast. North Carolina probably has me as excited as any up-and-coming program in America, Steve. We know what they did in-state last year. So last year, rearview mirror, we're starting to see those guys. As a matter of fact, in the spring game, we saw a lot of the guys that you and I had once talked about in the whip around. But now, looking forward, I was doing radio this morning. One of the first questions I got asked is, well, is North Carolina kind of going to be a flash that we enjoy for maybe a year or two, and then they kind of fade back into national mediocrity? Or is this a program that's recruiting at a level where they're going to be here to stay?
Well, I think they're recruiting at a level where they're one of the teams that could crash the party of the usual suspects that are in the mix for the national championship year in and year out. And here's why. Nobody's recruited the quarterback position better going back to Mack Brown and company, flipping Sam Howell from Florida State to North Carolina late in that cycle 2 years ago. Then they go out and land a four-star in Jacoby Criswell. And then they follow that up with Drake May, who was a five-star in the final top 247 for us. But then you look at these defensive linemen that they've recruited. These are the guys, these guys look like they play at Georgia and look like they play at LSU and look like they play at Alabama. That picture that we shared over Twitter of Keyshawn Silver and Jabari Ritzy, two true freshman defensive linemen. Silver walks in at 6'6", 275. Ritzy walks in at 6'5", 274. Silver's an outstanding basketball player at that size. Jabari Ritzy's an elite shot put discus guy. These guys are, I think, have put on 15 pounds already in Chapel Hill. They're monsters at the point of attack. And they're coming in behind the likes of Dez Evans and Miles Murphy. They're going to be deep on the defensive line. They're going to be ferocious on the defensive line. And they've recruited that position as well as Alabama and Clemson. They're living in that area code, recruiting at the point of attack. And then I think they've just landed a lot of speed all over the football field on both sides of the ball. They have a lot. They have SEC playmakers. They have SEC difference makers in the back seven. They have one of the best defensive coordinators in the country in Jay Bateman. They have one of the more efficient offensive coordinators in the country in Phil Longo. And then Mack Brown has just built a tremendous chemistry. You talk to people in that building, they love being there. The environment is terrific. The culture in the locker room with the players is off the charts. And then Ty Chandler was a sneaky big transfer portal pickup for them to kind of solidify a question mark on their offense after losing the two talented backs from last year. But to keep it rolling moving forward, to make sure that they are a mainstay in this conversation, and they're kind of building it like Clemson, right? Clemson built their powerhouse, landing blue chippers, but then also having some good evaluation wins along the way, and then player development and strong culture. North Carolina, two top 25 classes, positioned to do that again this cycle. But the biggest key for them on the trail is Travis Shaw. He's the number one player in the state. He's the number two defensive tackle nationally for the 24/7 Sports Composite. He's another one of those SEC type players in the middle. And I've had college coaches compare him to Derek Brown and the type of impact he can have in college football. And you look at Clemson, you look at Georgia, you look at North Carolina, you know, certainly you're going to see some of the other usual suspects in there, but that's one where North Carolina can follow up those two great defensive line classes with a Travis Shaw. You know, you're really rolling.
Loaded whip around this morning. Loaded. This is just out there on the internet, free for all to see. Steve Wiltfong, I'm Josh Pate. Thanks so much for watching. Keep it locked on 247sports.com for all the latest. Steve, and I will see you next week, sir.
Take care, y'all.